Ladies and gentlemen, in Minecraft 1.19, the Sculk Sensor becomes available both in Creative Mode through the Creative Inventory and in Survival Mode, where it can be found in the Deep Dark Biome and is generated by Sculk Catalysts. My name is slicedlime, and I'm here to show you all the details about how this block works. The Sculk Sensor is a new redstone component that detects vibrations. Many different events in the game emit such vibrations, which we'll get into the details about later. The range of detection for the Sculk Sensor is 9 blocks of spherical radius. When a vibration is detected, the Sculk Sensor triggers a redstone signal, which is stronger the closer to the sensor the event happened. The sensor picking up a vibration is not instant. When a vibration happens in the detection range of the sensor, a particle will start traveling from the source to the sensor at a speed of 1 block per tick, that is 20 blocks per second. When the particle has reached the sensor, it will activate for 2 seconds. From the very start of the particle traveling towards the sensor, through the entire activation and one more tick afterwards, the sensor is unable to detect other vibrations. If several vibrations are triggered during the same tick, the closest one to the sensor will be picked up. The block itself does not need support, so you can have it floating in the air and get the signal from underneath. It cannot be moved by pistons. The Sculk Sensor also makes a sound when it triggers. This can be muted by waterlogging the block. You can also read more information by connecting a comparator to the Sculk Sensor. It'll activate at the same time as the Sculk Sensor itself, but instead of the distance, the strength of the signal will indicate the type of the vibration. This is known as the vibration frequency. Let's go through the different types of vibrations and their frequencies. Frequency 1 is for footsteps and other vibrations caused by things moving on land, such as a boat being rowed on land or a minecart moving on a track. Frequency 2 is for wingbeats. Frequency 3 is for swimming in water and anything else moving in water like a boat or even a minecart moving underwater. This also includes walking in water. Frequency 4 is for flying elytra. Frequency 5 is hitting the ground after falling or teleporting. Frequency 6 is things splashing when entering or exiting water, wolves shaking the water out of their fur, a block changing or a note block playing. Frequency 7 is projectiles being fired, drinking a fluid, or igniting a TNT or a creeper. Frequency 8 is a projectile hitting anything, food being eaten, interacting with an entity, or an entity taking damage. Frequency 9 is equipping something, using shears, or a mob roaring. Frequency 10 is for dispensers failing to dispense, blocks closing, blocks deactivating, or a tripwire hook detaching. Frequency 11 is for blocks opening or activating and tripwire hooks attaching. Frequency 12 is for blocks, fluids or entities being placed. Frequency 13 is for the opposite, entities being killed, blocks being destroyed and fluids being picked up. Frequency 14 is for containers closing, pistons retracting and finishing interacting with an item. And frequency 15 is for containers being opened, pistons extending, playing an instrument and for lightning strikes and explosions. If you've found this helpful this far, please take a moment to send some vibrations to the like sensor of the video. That helps out get the video shown on YouTube, so I appreciate the help. Thank you. There are also some ways to avoid detection by a Sculk Sensor. Some types of vibrations can be avoided by sneaking. They are walking and swimming, landing on the ground, shooting projectiles, and interacting with items. Wool also has the ability to block vibrations. This means you can occlude vibrations by placing wool in between the source of a vibration and the sensor, or place wool underneath to dampen footsteps. Wool block items also do not trigger vibrations when dropped on the ground. And that's it for the Sculk Sensor. Thank you for watching the entire video, I do appreciate it. If you're interested in more information about this update, also check out the video linked right here.